The other two freak identities, which is in the same category, if you recall, if you don't remember or you don't recognize, that's fine, but you can derive it by dividing the one that you use all the time here by psi square x. If you divide each term by psi square x, what do you get? Psi square x over psi square x, you get one, correct? Cosine over psi. What is cosine over psi? What is cosine square x over psi square x? You can type in the chat box if you would like to help me. What is cosine over psi? If you know what cosine over psi, please type in the chat so I can see, I can verify. Cotangent, thank you. So meet one plus cotangent, COT, cotangent square x. How about one over psi square x? What would that be? What is one over psi squared? Cosecant, yes, gonna be power two, cosecant square x. And the other group, I'm gonna still stick with this one, right? So for this, that's my superstar there. So divided by cosine square x. If we divide the same trick identity here that what we use all the time, each term by cosine squared instead. So the first one, we have psi square x over cosine square x. The second term, cosine square over cosine square, yes, we're gonna get one. Okay, so, and then the right-hand side gonna be one over cosine square x. And now, could you tell me again, what is sine over cosine? Tangent, thank you. So tangent squared plus one equals, how about one over cosine squared? Yes, secant squared, secant square x. And see, you can derive the next two identities without memorizing too many things by using what you already know. You already know sine squared plus cosine squared equals one. And then you can treat one at a time by dividing by sine squared x. So you derive another trick identity, another trick identity. So why I brought this up? Because I wanted you to see the relationship. The first one here, just different color, see if I can. So for the first one here, you see the relationship of sine and cosine, okay? Sine and cosine. The second one here is cotangent and cosecant. You see C and C, cotangent, cosecant, other than the sine, cosine. Sine and cosine always together. And the next one is the tangent and the secant. So as you can group them at three other groups, the sine, cosine, cotangent, cosecant, tangent, and secant, it's gonna help you recognize the formula to find the derivative in the easier way without memorizing too many things. Okay, so now get to the derivatives here. You have six of them, sine, cosine, tangent, cosecant, cotangent, and the secant. For the group of the sine and cosine, derivative of sine is cosine. Derivative of cosine is negative sine. Excuse me. And then the other group, the tangent, secant, the cotangent, cosecant. All right. Beyond that, the reason that I put in two groups, the right group, you can see the trig function start with the C. Okay. For the one that start with the C, the cosine, cotangent, cosecant, you have the derivative with the negative sign. The left group, they didn't begin with the letter C. So the derivative will not come out as a plain one, no negative sign involving to begin with. And then next group, the sine and cosine. Derivative of the sine is cosine. Derivative of the cosine is negative because begin with the same negative sign. So this is the group of the sine and cosine. Okay. The next one, the tangent and the secant, both of them, they don't begin with the letter C. So the derivative is going to be positive. So the derivative of the tangent is secant squared. Derivative of the secant is secant times tangent. How do I recognize it in the easiest way? In the easy way. So this is one of the techniques. Or you can look it up, you know, to Google, YouTube. Say so there are tons of tips and tricks to recognize this. And this is one of them. Then you already know the relationship of tangent and secant. So the way that we would use it to recognize it in the easiest way. So you write them down like this, with the tangent, secant, okay? And same way as a cotangent and cosecant, cotangent, cosecant, cosecant. So what I usually do, and when I began to, you know, start to put pieces together and to recognize it, I would start with the cotangent, cosecant. So I won't kind of the reminder to me, like cosecant has two C. So I'm gonna have like two factors of the cosecant. And then same cosecant and cotangent, they are in the same group. So I line them up like this. All of them, both of them begin with the letter C. So I'm gonna have negative sign. Once I form this set, I do similar way for the tangent and secant. The tangent multiplied by secant, but plus sign in the front. And to get the derivative, if I find the derivative of the tangent, I kind of cover the tangent x, the leftover would be secant squared or secant times secant. And in similar way, if I write out the same pattern, but now I'm gonna find the derivative of the secant, the rest of the product would be tangent times secant, which is this derivative. Okay, I got this set taken care of. And next set, for the derivative of the cotangent, I cover the cotangent. Now I have the product of the cosecant and cosecant with a negative sign, which is negative cosecant squared x. Another derivative, I rewrite it. Negative cotangent, cosecant, cosecant. This time I'm gonna find the derivative of cosecant. So I have negative cotangent x cosecant x as the derivative of it. Okay, so this is one of the techniques to recognize the derivative of the trig functions without memorizing too many things.